All right, here we go. I'm gonna do a tutorial. CSSI the donut asked, how do you do that targy thing while I'm the last guy? I think I know how to do it, but it would be shitty probably. Thanks. Which is at this part right here. That thing, right there. This little, it's probably harder shit to see, but anyway, that's what it is. Okay, so here's how I did it. Actually, all I did, because I made this old 3D thing and I didn't want to discard it totally, so I kind of just took that, but I guess the best way to do it would be Photoshop, so I'll whip that out real quick. File, new, 1280 by 720, transparent background, that's cool. Alright, I have a couple of brush packs we could use, but I'll try to keep it as default as possible. Okay, so I'm just gonna pick a nice blue, like that. Okay. Hold shift, and then we're gonna draw one circle. Paint it. Control A. And then you'll hit this button and this button that centers it. Okay. And then we're gonna make another circle, a little bit smaller. Paint it. Control A. Hit that pointer tool, center it. Control D. Control D again. And I'm just going to make this circle big enough to where it helps. If you know what I mean. Okay. Grab this wand tool, see how big it is. That's pretty good. Okay. So now I'm going to hit select inverse. Turn off this layer, go to the bottom layer, hit delete, and we have a open circle. Right click, duplicate layer. Okay, control T, hold down shift, make it smaller, so that if you move it in here, it'll be a good size, maybe a little tinier. Apply it up, boom, boom, duplicate it again, control T, make it smaller so it fits within there, apply. Boom, we have this little targety thing. If you want, you can hit your eraser tool and make it like really interesting looking. I guess I'll just make it look prettier than it did in the clip. Hit it on that layer. Hit that layer. You can just download some brushes. You don't have to do this. This is just something that might look cool. Okay, turn off those two layers. Actually, I might want to make these prettier. Blending options, maybe like a gradient overlay, and then set the mode to, I don't know, overlay. No. I can just keep playing with these until I get one that looks kind of cool. That looks good, soft light. So I'll add a gradient overlay and change the blend mode to soft light on all of them. Right click, blending options, gradient overlay. And soft light. Boom. Okay. Now I'm going to save all these layers separate. So file, save as. I'll just put them on my desktop target tutorial. I'll do you as one. Okay. File, save as. Two. Okay. And go file. Save as 3. Okay, now we're done with the Photoshop part. I'm gonna open up my videos, the clip of the week, and I'll just open up that same clip, which was called default clip of the week.avi. File, open with Sony Vegas. Alright, I'm just going to change the properties real quick. I have a default setting that I use. Save me on time. There's another one of those you can use. I can't remember which one it is. Whoops. Cancel. Okay. Screw it. You can figure it out for yourself. Alright, file, import. Go to desktop. Target tutorial. I guess that's what we'll call it. And you're going to open all those three layers. And insert video track. Drop all three of them up here, insert video track, until we have three tracks here and here. Okay. Now let's go to the point where we're about to follow this guy, which is about here. Here to there. So I'll cut these down a little bit. Go to here. 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 Alright, we're good to go. Now what we're gonna do is I'm just gonna first off get the position set for all these. So you're gonna right click event pan crop and you're gonna put the about the middle of the circle in this guy. Scale forward a few frames. Make sure the middle of the circle's on them. If it goes off a little bit, you can just keep playing with it. You can also use track map, but I'm just gonna use pan crops, that's what I always use. He starts to jump, follow him as he jumps. Starts to jump more. Follow him up there. He starts to fall. Fall him as he falls. And he falls even more. And then you spray him down. So move it up a little bit. There. Okay, now I'm gonna highlight all these. Copy. Open this up. Right click paste. And then open this up. Right click paste. Okay. And if you render it, you got a target thing. Clean it up a little bit, add fades on it. Here, here, and here, and here, and here, and here. We have a little target thing.